Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Today I'm talking about bruising and lip fillers. It's so common when you get a new patient or you're about to inject, I always ask, what have you had done? Take a history and find out, why are you here? Why did you, if you had a lip filler before, why did you change clinics? And sometimes you hear, well, I went to so-and-so and they bruised me, so I'm changing clinics and coming here. And I always make it a point, as many of you do, to let people know that bruising is a normal part of when you get a needle in the face. It can happen, it doesn't happen all the time, and there's needles versus cannulas and different reasons, but you can get swelling, you can get bruising, and you're gonna look different, at least initially when you get lip fillers. And so it's part of the process. We always like patients to have about 2 weeks of grace period before everything looks perfect. But I thought I'd go through a few things that you can do to help prevent bruising. And no matter what you do, if you follow all these things and your own methods to avoid them, it's still possible to get a bruise. It's part of the process, it's normal. Now, bruising and vascular events are two different things, so I'm not talking about a bruise that might be something worse. So always ask your provider and be in touch with them. If something seems abnormal, there's pain or bruise, because it can masquerade as a bigger problem. But a regular bruise is a normal part. Let's go through some things that you can do to prevent them. So the number one thing is needle versus a cannula. If people absolutely can't bruise, but they still want to get fillers, particularly lip fillers, if I use a microcannula, the chance of bruising, the risk goes way down, maybe by about 80 to 95% reduction in risk by using that cannula. Sometimes we need to fine tune with a little needle, but at least we can do the majority of work with a 25 gauge microcannula, and bruising becomes very rare. So how it's done, that's the first thing. Number two is not taking aspirin or anti-inflammatories for about 12 days. Yes, 12 days, it kills the platelets for a number of days when you take those medications. So aspirin, ibuprofen's not as bad, Aleve, and those are some of the medications that should be avoided prior if you don't want to bruise. The third is red wine or wine. I hate to ruin the parade, but yes, wine will make people bruise. It's something that a lot of people don't have to avoid. I wouldn't run out and stop enjoying life just to get your lip filler, but if you absolutely knew you were getting it, you didn't want to bruise, again, it's probably more like a week to two that you have to stop before. The night of or 2 days before won't do much, but red wine will affect it. Number four, supplements. So things like vitamin E, fish oil, some people say ginseng. If you avoid those, it will help avoid bruising, because what do? They help prevent heart disease by thinning the blood a little bit. We definitely see, I put good fish oil on par with someone being on aspirin, and aspirin is one of the worst anti-inflammatories. So stop those things, again, at least 10 days before your treatment. Number five, arnica. You can start arnica about 2 or 3 days prior to your treatment. I like oral pill form, and find out how to use the one you're using. There's many different ways to take it orally and when you should take food in between, but arnica does help prevent bruising. If you can, start it a day or two before, but then continue it for about 5 days after the treatment, and that will help prevent a bruise. And if you get one, it seems to reduce the amount of time the bruise stays around. Number six, exercise. So don't exercise after the filler. I always tell my patients, take a day off, 24 hours is good. If you were to get something done and you go out and particularly get your heart rate up or do cardio type exercise, that can then lead to a bruise. People leave and they look great, they don't have any bruising. If they're on aspirin, or anti-inflammatories, they get delayed bruising. Same with exercise. So they'll go out, everything looks great. That evening they go and exercise and boom, a bruise forms. So that can happen. Because you have a filler, you have a gel-like substance in there, and then you have a lot of movement and blood flow that goes to the area to heal it, and now you've increased that. So it increases the risk. So a bruise, a normal bruise, is part of the process of getting fillers and possibly lip fillers, because even if you get cannulas, people often touch them up and fine tune them with needles. Let us know your experience with lip fillers. Do you have any other tips to avoid bruising? Let us know below. Also, follow us on Instagram, this YouTube channel. You can subscribe for updates and tips and tricks to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.